Eric, back in naturopath, we're still talking about antibiotics. Is it good to take a round of probiotics after you've had a round of antibiotics?
Well, I think it is.
A study conducted in Israel a few years ago says that it's sort of not really good, or it's debatable. But these studies involve mice, laboratories, test tubes, you know, and humans as well. And it always makes me suspicious, you know, under what methods these studies are conducted, how they work, and then how they come to their conclusions. And so remember, studies don't give 100% definitive yes or no, like this is crap, it doesn't work, or yes, it's brilliant. It's not like that at all. In fact, it's very, very difficult to perform several studies and come out with a good conclusion regarding something. So I believe in studies, but I also believe in empirical observation, in looking at the patient in front of me to see what happens, you know, with that patient when something's introduced, and then watching that patient over a period of weeks, months, and years. I did that for over 25 plus years with thousands of people. That to me is not necessarily what you call science, but you know what? It worked for me, and it worked for a lot of my patients because I followed them on through. So each patient becomes a study in itself when you think about it. So to give a definitive answer how long a probiotic is going to be a benefit for, how long it needs to be taken for after the antibiotic, is a very difficult question to answer. I've often had people email me when they were patients saying, Eric, how long do I stay on this? I've taken, you know, erythromycin or tetracycline or Cipro I was on for, you know, 10 to 14 days. How long do I take a probiotic for? Well, the general consensus is it takes on average between 3 to 6 months to get the gut into pretty good shape after an antibiotic. But in some cases, it can take 12 months. In some cases, it can take 3 weeks. It really depends on the state of your gut before you took the antibiotic. It also depends on your lifestyle after you've taken the antibiotic, like what you're eating, how you're living, how you're sleeping, how you're working. All those factors come into account on how quick the microbiome will be restored. So needless to say, you know, my take on it, eating lots of plant-based foods is, you know, with natural sugars and fibers will help speed up the rebuild of the microbiome. A stressful job, a stressful relationship, traveling a lot, you know, corporate jobs, single mums, people looking after, caring for unwell relatives, these things all delay. Stress delays the microbiome restoration incredibly. It's something I witnessed with so many patients for so long now, and you don't read about that in studies much. A lot of these things aren't really like studied properly, okay? It's very hard to study stress, but I've seen the effects on stress on the gut, and to me, it's almost as bad as taking the antibiotic, how the gut gets affected by stress. The person makes all these weird decisions when they're stressed, and the gut doesn't function really well at all under stress. So the question again was, how long should you take a probiotic after a round of antibiotics? I would look at the digestive health. Let's just say, for example, I was on an antibiotic for 2 weeks. I wouldn't take antibiotics, but if I was on it for 2 weeks, then I would look at the functioning of my gut after that, and I would certainly stay with the diet I've always had and expect it to rebuild quite quick. I'd go on a probiotic straight away. I don't take them now, but if I had to take an antibiotic, I would. I would take it twice a day, and I would take it at least for 3 months, for 12 weeks. But don't listen to people who say for every day you've been on antibiotic, you need so many days on. I mean, that's all, it's all bunkum. Nobody really knows that at all, okay? Look at your bowel motions. Look at the bloating. Look at the gas. Look at the appetite. Look at your overall health. See how it's improving under the effects of the good diet and the probiotic. That will give you some guideline, especially the stool. Is it shaped? Is it well formed? Is it easy to pass? You feel quite good when you've had a bowel motion. Or have you still got loose stool and bloating and gas and things that could determine that you've got a problem with your gut? Another trick is, if you're not really recovering after the antibiotic, is get a stool test done. Even just a basic one to see if there's yeast there. Because so many people develop a yeast infection in their gut after an antibiotic, it's almost ridiculous. So there could well be a chance you could have a mild yeast infection going on there that may need sorting. So here's even better advice. If you've got that kind of situation where you don't think you're recovering, I would be looking at the intake of garlic, and probably other kind of, you know, different foods in the diet, they're going to help also suppress the yeast. So you may need to up the garlic intake if you're not really fully recovering. Now, garlic doesn't kill beneficial bacteria. A lot of people believe that it destroys beneficial. In fact, it's a prebiotic. So it just shows you these weird misconceptions online, doesn't it? So there is no such thing as a standard size piece of rope, if you know what I mean. How long is a piece of rope? Is it 6 inches? Is it 6 miles? They all vary in length, just like recovery times vary depending on all those factors I've spoken about. But let's just say 3 to 6 months on average, and then take it from there. Thanks for tuning in.